everyone, and welcome. I'm sure everyone's a little hungry, but I think this is going to be a good talk, and then we'll proceed to lunch. So thank you, Sean, for the introduction. We're really happy to be back here. We've been in business now just over a year, and we've learned a lot this past year about the market, about new products that different formulation companies are producing, and we're really excited to be back here. So the demand for CBD is obviously growing in the United States. It, of course, offers very distinct advantages when compared to traditional opioid medicines. And several events have happened in the past year where you see states sort of going against pharma companies and different medical journals and clinical studies now linking prescription drugs to many deaths. So people are looking at CBD as a very superior alternative to these opioids. Of course, it's non-psychoactive, not addictive, all of the good things that were talked about in the last panel. And there's multiple medical benefits. And we're looking forward to the days that clinical studies are allowed and there could be proper research done on CBD. There's also growing agency support where you have organizations such as the World Health Organization approving CBD and different grassroots organizations. And recently was Mitch McConnell, the Senate Majority Leader, who plans to introduce a bill for legalization of industrial hemp. So a lot of exciting things are going on in this industry, and they're all helping us processors to become even more legitimate. Just a little overview about Kazmira. So we are one of the leading suppliers of THC-free CBD oil in the United States. We also make isolate as well, but the product that we're most known for is the THC-free CBD oil. We were actually the first company to put this true THC-free oil out in the market a few years ago. We've recently expanded our facility size. We now have a 200,000 square foot facility that we do processing with, as well as storage of hemp. We utilize a state-of-the-art purification technology that allows us to make the THC-free CBD oil, but also other oils that have various terpenes in them, as well as different cannabinoids, depending on the hemp feedstock that we receive. As Sean pointed out, we have many engineers that work for us. We have a couple of PhDs, some master's students, a lot of bachelor level chemical engineers and scientists. And Pulak and I come from a background of process engineering. So we're very aware of what type of learning needs to be done for process engineers and what type of exercises we need to teach our engineers in order to be more efficient at their jobs. We have all the required permits and licenses to operate in the state of Colorado. So this would be the CDPHE food manufacturing license. And we also have ISO 9001, which is a quality management license that's given to any and all pharmaceutical companies, as well as oil and gas companies, which we're both had experience in. And this really shows that the company cares about tracking batches and quality management standards. Last year, we did plant 240 acres of industrial hemp in Colorado. We're planning to do more this coming year. So we have a couple of contract grows going on. We're very excited about what's happening in the farming industry as far as different varietals of industrial hemp. This is a picture of part of our facility. We have class one, div one facilities. So what this means is essentially stands for explosion proof facility. Now, pharmaceutical companies and oil and gas refineries all operating with equipment have facilities in this type of environment. So if you ever go to a facility where you see all of the electrical work outside of where the equipment is inside the room, This will designate that it's class 1 div 1. And this is something really important that we talk about with many people who are interested in entering the industry with supercritical CO2 extractions and light hydrocarbon extractions. You need to be operating in a safe facility that's rated for that technology, and that is class 1 div 1. We're working on our GMP compliance right now, and of course we have EPA permits, and this is necessary for any and all companies that are working with solvents, because you'll ultimately have hazardous waste that you'll have to deal with. So this is also something that we talk to companies about looking for doing processing, is getting EPA permits as well. Now, just an overview of our process. We're able to take industrial hemp in different forms. That would be the powdered form. There's also sticks and stems. And through this industrial hemp, we extract and make an extracted juice. And this differs, of course, based on the feedstock that we get. So we can have higher CBG, for instance. Last month, we had a high CBC feedstock, so that was an interesting product from there. And from this extracted juice, we go into our purification technology, which again allows us to make products such as isolate, such as THC-free oil, as well as THC-free oil with different potencies. The most common one that we produce for our customers is the 80% THC-free oil, and this is produced using our purification technology. So we ultimately, you know, we're vertically integrated because we are able to control the quality all the way from the industrial hemp feedstock to the final product. And we believe that this is what has made us successful and has allowed us to continue scaling up each month, is because we follow those quality management standards. And it helps our company just to be more organized and have your goals, you know, just more organized. So I'm going to hand it to Pulak now. He's going to talk to you about different technologies available in the industry that are used for extractions right now. As well as a bonus of how to make 10,000 kilos a month. And the reason we included this slide in our talk is because we get calls every other day now for production of that scale. And we sat down this week and kind of looked at, you know, what that would be. So for anyone interested in making product at that scale, please, you know, please listen to Pulak, and he's going to teach you guys.
All right. Hello? Can everyone hear me okay?
All right.
Okay, everyone. So, you know, Priyanka has kind of give you an overview of Kazmira in terms of our production capacity, the technology we're using. The other component of this presentation is really focusing on what are the different technologies that are out there that people use to make the, you know, the CBD products. And so the two most common ones you see here are the supercritical CO2 as well as the light hydrocarbon extraction, right? So those are very popular there. I mean, I think there's a few folks at the conference here who have brought some of their units that have these characteristics. And at a high level, you know, the thing to focus on is the operating conditions. So you can see that they have very high pressure requirements, as well as various swings in temperature, right? So what that does is, you know, 5,000 PSI is a lot of pressure, right? So what that does is it allows they can extract out the other cannabinoids using these different technologies, but it also has some downside, and that ends up being usually you lose some terpenes, some other cannabinoids that may not come out. There's some yield loss, and the yield loss can add up, right? And so, especially when you're trying to make isolate, what happens is you start with these technologies, and then you do some distillation to try to get the CBD out from the other chlorophyll and other plant matter that you found in the extracted oil from these two different technologies. And that just adds up over and over again, especially when you're trying to go to CBD isolate. So the yield ends up being, you know, 30%, 20%, which means if I put in 100 grams of CBD into the machine, at the end, I'll probably get out 20 grams of CBD isolate. And the rest of the material is, of course, has a lot of THC, right? So it becomes very difficult for that to go anywhere. And that's where, you know, you see a lot of swings in being able to scale up these technologies. Okay, so here's the slide that Priyanka mentioned. You know, what does it take to make 10,000 kilos? Pretty popular slide, looks like, of per month using some of these technologies. So what we did is, you know, as engineers, we focus on the assumptions. What does it take to get to that? You can see that, you know, the goal is to produce 10,000 kilos a month. And then if you just do some rough math, you know, this is back of the napkin math, you have, let's assume, about 5 to 6% CBD in the hemp, which is pretty garden variety. Usually, industrial hemp is lower. I think they may have mentioned that at the talk before, but you know, you would see 3 to 4%. The stuff that you're seeing in the market, the really high end, 10 to 12%, that ends up being much more low volume because the genetics are much harder. So, if you assume about 6% hemp and assume 30% yield, that's about 14 million pounds per year that you have to process. 14 million pounds, pardon my French, is a shitload. So that causes, I mean, just imagine 14 million pounds needs to fit in here. So what the takeaway from here is, if, you know, everybody's getting into the industry, and then that's very exciting, but I think it creates a lot of hysteria. Where a lot of folks start believing that, you know, 14 million pounds can be housed in a very small location. So what we come across every single day is being compared with other, you know, other manufacturers who may not have the right facility size to accommodate 14 million pounds, let alone make 10 kilos. Or that 10,000 kilos. Okay, so just at a high level, what are the different market opportunities that you see, and why this industry is, you know, really blown up? Last year, you know, the place we were at was much smaller. This is incredible to see how much it's grown, and it's very exciting. So a lot of these facts we got from, you know, from Sean himself and from a few other folks that we know, but at a high level, there's 10,000, thousands of pounds of acres that were grown in the United States for industrial hemp farming. Of course, we haven't talked about how much is for seed, which is how much is for CBD production. That's a different conversation. And then we have various application, 50 plus end applications for these products. In fact, we just tried cookie dough with CBD. That was pretty damn good. And then you can also see, you know, these different applications from nutraceutical to pharmaceutical applications to everything in between for CBD. But the biggest thing that we see is a lot of opportunity for innovation.
Can I have that? Is that on?
Yeah.
Okay. So the biggest thing we see is the opportunities for innovation. And I think for us as a large-scale producer, the biggest one is going to be yield, right? We have to find a way to get the entire industry to increase the yield amount because that's really, really important. Otherwise, you're just losing a lot of the CBD in lower value add oils that, you know, you end up having to dilute, and it just dilutes the entire CBD itself, right? Because you end up just diluting it. You don't get as much of the benefit of the CBD. And then as industrial hemp increases in demand, it's going to create more of a agricultural commodity, right? Eventually it's going to get there, which what that means is you have to be able to farm it at large scale, like you do corn and other commodities. And what that does is to get to that level, the CBD percentage in the hemp, it will be lower. So it'll be 2, 3, 4, 5%. And you have to find a way to extract that. That's much more difficult than extracting some of the high-end CBD hemp that you see right now that's 10 to 15% CBD, right? It, becomes much more difficult because you have to concentrate and then you have to purify to a much more difficult level, the CBD concentration. Okay. And then, of course, the simple one is automation. You know, you need bigger tanks, you need piping, you need all that good stuff to really make it a world-class operation for the whole industry from a purification and extraction standpoint. You'll see more genetics coming up of how do we increase the plants, how do we increase the cannabinoid content. Of course, there's a huge demand for CBC and CBG and CBN, all those different cannabinoids that are found in the plant, and we will see increased demand for that, and of course, that will create its own niche industries. And a very important one is the equipment, right, that you're using. So as Priyanka mentioned, the equipment is rated properly, it's in a actual facility, and is used to do the job that it's meant to do and not something different. And then the last point is we're creating a lot of spent hemp, right? All the hemp that's left over. What are you going to do with that? So at Kazmira, we actually make hemp pellets out of it, and have some, you know, we've contracted out some farms that are horse farms or alpaca farms that buy the pellets. Well, we just give it to them, but they use it for bedding, right? We can't feed the cows yet, right? But we give it for bedding, and that's quite popular. They like that a lot. And then just a quick plug for Kazmira is the, we just introduced actually, from a product standpoint, what are the innovations that are out there? We just introduced a water-soluble CBD product that is about 5,000 milligrams of CBD in a 500 milliliter bottle, which is quite incredible. Usually we see, you know, 5 to 10 milligrams in a bottle. So we've developed that concentrate that can then be easily dispensed out to many different organizations.
Okay, so just want to thank you all for attending our talk. We're at booth number 12, but we'll also be at lunch if anyone has any questions. And we always invite anyone and everyone to come visit us at our facility. We'd love to talk to you about the hemp industry, however you want to get involved. We'd be happy to discuss that. So thank you.
Thank you.